while some of you are still discovering the new features and improvements in Firefox 83. Mozilla is already working on the next major version of the popular and open source web browser, Firefox 84, which promises to finally enable the web renderer feature by default on Linux. Coming up on Runboxing. Written in Rust, the web renderer feature in Firefox makes the entire web browser faster when surfing the internet. While web render is known for being extremely fast, it also makes Firefox more stable and smoother. Until now, Firefox shipped with web renderer disabled by default for Linux users, but that's about to change with the upcoming release, Firefox 84. To enable web renderer in Linux, you had to access the About Configuration page, search for the gfx.webrender.all settings and set it to true. Web renderer wasn't enabled on Linux until now because it may cause instability or other issues for some users, especially on WLAN, where things are still experimental these days. With the upcoming Firefox 84 release, web renderer will apparently be enabled by default on Linux systems running on X11, not WLAN. It also looks like Mozilla will enable web renderer on Firefox 84 for Linux platforms running the GNOME desktop environment. That's a bit strange, but I believe it should also work well on other desktops that use the GTK technologies such as Mate or XFCE if this is a GTK or Qt thing. Besides that, Firefox 84 will be the final release to support Adobe's controversial Flash Player plugin, which is set to reach end of life at the end of 2020. Future releases of Firefox web browser starting with version 85 won't ship with Adobe Flash support, improving performance and security. Also, Firefox 84 will load all of Mozilla's trusted intermediate certificate authorities on new profiles in a single day. From remote settings to avoid any security error or misconfigured website, Firefox 84 is now available for public beta testing. But the first beta release doesn't ship with the web renderer enabled by default on Linux or X11 or GNOME. Most probably, the feature will be enabled in later releases or in the final release, which is expected in mid-December. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit the thumbs up button. It helps me make a good content for you. Other than that, I'll see you in tomorrow's video. Peace out.